There's so many negative people in this world. Tune them out. Tune out toxic people. Tune out toxic stocks. Focus on the positive. Focus on yourself. You will be surprised at what you can accomplish with enough dedication, with enough patience, especially if you love what you do. It's all about passion.
Guys, welcome to the 1%er podcast. This is your host, Sam Bakhtiar. I'm going to have my man, Timothy Sykes, in the house. Timothy is known as someone who's earned $1.6 million by day trading while attending Tulane University. He's also been a guest on the biggest TV shows like in the world, including Steve Harvey Show and Larry King Show. He's a co-founder of Karmagawa.
Yeah.
You know, with 1.1 million followers on IG, you know, and Save the Reef that has 700,000 followers on IG. My man has 1.5 million followers, you know, 390,000 followers on YouTube and 250,000 on Twitter. My man, you're absolutely crushing it.
Thank you. Thank you. Just getting started. When you love what you do, it looks good from the outside. But for me, it's just, you know, I'm very blessed, very fortunate for it all.
Brother, I want to know about, you know, your day trading, your penny stock trading. You know, let's get to the money right away.
Let's do it.
Let's get to the money right away, man. What the hell? How the hell did you do that?
I didn't mean to. You know, I was a tennis player. I got injured. And so I got started, you know, just trading in the stock market. I couldn't afford big companies. So I really gravitated towards low price stocks and got very good at it. I take the meat of the move. I don't believe in any of the companies, but I try to ride the hype. You know, so there's a lot of hype all the time in so many different industries. And I try to make, you know, $1,000, $2,000 per trade, and it adds up. I'm now up to 6 million. I donate all of my trading profits to charity these days. I started with a few thousand dollars, but now, you know, $1 million, but I show my screen, I show what I'm looking at, and I teach people. So it's very interactive, and I have, you know, now over 9,000 students in 140 countries, and, you know, very proud to just, you know, cut through the BS in my industry and recognize that most of these penny stocks are crap. Most of these companies will fail, but their stocks are very volatile and they double, triple, quadruple in a day or two. And now with the stock market at all-time highs, I mean, it's just been a crazy few months.
Wow. Wow. So your main business right now is teaching penny stocks.
Yeah. Okay. Trading.
Yeah. Penny stocks, trading penny stocks.
So not investing. Very big difference. A lot of people believe in these companies. They think it's the next Microsoft. It never is. I always teach my students to expect the worst out of people, to expect the worst out of these companies. And I know that's a cynical way of looking at it, but most of these penny stock companies will fail. And you just have to be aware of that. You can't fall in love with the technologies. They all claim that they're going to change the world. They're all, you know, going to cure cancer. They never do, but they can be, you know, ridden for their volatility, and you can use your small account to your advantage. Too many people with small accounts are trying to trade like Apple and, you know, Zoom, which we're doing this on, or, you know, Tesla, and the percentage gains are very small for a small account. So I want to utilize small accounts to your advantage. And I say trade like a sniper and take small gains. You know, one of my sayings is 2K a day keeps the real job away. And, you know, two grand.
2K a day is real, definitely will keep the job away, man. 2K a month will keep the job away from me.
But you have to understand, on Wall Street, 2 grand a day is looked down upon. They're like, you're not a real trader. You only make it that. And I'm like, I mean, I'm from a small town in Connecticut. $2,000 a day is more than enough for me. More than enough for my students.
I'm from a small town in Pennsylvania. So 2K, you know, that's a good living there. You know what I mean? So,
But there's a lot of snobs on Wall Street, and that's the difference. Like, you know, you have everyone like, oh, you know, not $1 million is cool. It's $1 billion. And I'm like, I only have a few million dollars in my account and I'm living pretty well. And I'm not a slave to my job. I travel all over the world. I've been to over 120 countries. Normally I would be traveling right now, but with the pandemic, I've been forced to really just, you know, focus on trading, which isn't that bad either.
So from what I'm hearing, you know, whenever you say penny stocks, you know, the Wolf of Wall Street movie comes in my head. And what he was telling people is to invest in them, right? But you tell them, no, don't invest in them. He was telling them, put your money and invest in penny stocks. And you tell them, you're saying right here that most of the companies not going anywhere. I mean, all of them pretty much are not going anywhere. You know, they're being volatile, but that just because they're volatile, that doesn't mean you can't ride a quick wave and make some quick buck, right?
Exactly.
You know, and basically what I'm hearing from you is, unless you have a lot of money, you know, to invest in real companies, you know, you're not going to get any gains. You know, you spend a couple of $1,000s on Apple, you know, your gains ain't going to be that good. You know what I mean? Your gains not going to be so you got to invest that couple of $1,000s in penny stocks and be able to trade with penny stocks and be able to make some good money, good return on that $2,000, right? And putting on Apple and maybe making 30, 40 cents here and there.
And that's the point. You know, the Wolf of Wall Street, what he was doing was illegal. He was specifically, you know, pumping and dumping these companies, and he was telling other people to invest while he was selling. For me, I show my screen. You can see my trades. I take very small positions. I'm like, okay, my goal here is to make 15%, or my goal here is to make 25%. Rule number one is cut losses quickly. I actually lose on a third of my trades, but my losses are $50, $100, $200. My gains are $1,000, $2,000, $3,000. So my account grows over time if I stay disciplined. I'm basically teaching people discipline. I'm trying to teach degenerate gamblers how not to be so degenerate anymore. And
investing, you know, is a discipline, though. I mean, the greatest investor in the world, Warren Buffett, he's the most disciplined person when it comes to that. And I think discipline is vital to everything you do in life, whether it's working out, whether it's investing, whether it's business, you know, and it is to make sure that you don't let your emotions, you know, take away from your game plan. Have a game plan, stick to your game plan. Yes, sometimes you can ride that emotion and make a little extra bucks, but in the long run, it's going to come back and bite you.
You would make a great trader. This is what this is all about. It's taking small gains and being okay with it. Like today, I took gains. I'm up about $942 so far in the morning. If I held, I could be up like 3,000. I don't care. I'm not trying to pick the exact top. I'm trying to take the meat of the move, which I do. So sometimes I sell too soon. Sometimes I sell too late. But as long as I'm in the groove with my process, my account grows. So if you're meticulous, and this goes with, you know, investing or fitness or business or in life, if you're meticulous, if you wake up early, if you plan ahead when everyone else is just kind of being like, let me do this, let me do that. No real plan, no preparation. You have an edge. You have an advantage. You have higher specific odds on every task that you do the more that you plan. And this is why I'm so energetic. I wake up early. I go to bed early. I'm always thinking about how can I benefit my students these days. And that is how I create better testimonials. That's how my business has grown. My top student has made nearly triple what I have made in half the time because I've taught him everything. I never had a teacher. So I'm trying to mentor to people that I never had.
Awesome. So let's say I'm interested, you know, in trading, right? You know, penny stocks.
Yeah.
You know, and let's say, you know, you have a course or mentorship program, you know, and all that. How easy it is for me to get started? How fast can I start making some money?
It's very easy to get started. It's not easy to make money right away. You know, my top student, he might have made over $13 million. He made nothing his first 9 months. So he's studying, he's learning. A lot of my lessons are very counterintuitive. People, you know, don't want to like just sit there and learn for 9 months and not make anything. They're like, come on. But you have to learn the process. And it's not always 9 months. You know, he got started several years ago. The market wasn't as hot. Today, the market is hotter. Don't even, you know, buy anything. Most people think I'm a scam when they first hear about me anyway. So I have 1,500 free videos on my YouTube channel. Just do a search for Timothy Sykes. See all my trades. I show live trades. I have student trades. I show my wins. My best, you know, video lessons are when I have a loss and I teach what I did right, what I did wrong. So it's just about, you know, learning what is real in the trading industry, because industry stats say that 90% of traders lose and no one talks about that. You know, you have E-Trade babies on commercials and they're like, look how easy it is to get started. And you see a little dancing baby. If that were realistic, it would be a bloody bruised baby. It would be all blurred out because the baby would be battered from this battlefield that is trading. So I'm kind of like a drill sergeant teaching my students, teaching my, you know, army, I guess you could call them, how to survive in battle.
Got it. You know, man, so is there, man, you know, I would love to do this, but I don't want to learn it. I would love to just hire somebody and give them a percentage of it. Is that service available?
No, I don't manage anybody else's money. If you're already making good money, you don't need to trade. This is for people with very little money. You know, they have a lot of time on their hands, especially now with the pandemic. My business has just catapulted because people are, you know, usually just watching Netflix or playing video games. They're bored. Why not learn a new skill? But if you're already successful, you already have millions of dollars, you don't need trading penny stocks, okay? It's a lot of time with, you know, a lot of effort and very little reward. This is for people with a few thousand dollars to their name, a lot of time, and not just about the money, it's wanting to learn a new skill, learning how finance works, learning how investor psychology works, like learning how to sell into strength, buy into fear. You have to go against the crowd, and that's very difficult to teach. It's very difficult to implement in the beginning, but then, you know, you start getting used to it 2 years, 3 years. My most successful students are 3-4 years in.
Got it. Got it. That's awesome, man. Well, you know, I can't wait to go check out some of your videos on your YouTube channel.
You'll laugh. I cut through a lot of BS, you know. I don't hold any budges back.
I can tell, man. I can tell, you know, you're so energetic. You're so pumped up. I can tell that you're so passionate about what you do. And that's what makes you, you know, makes you awesome. So tell me about your experience, you know, being on the Steve Harvey Show. How the hell did you get on the Steve Harvey Show?
So this is what's so crazy. It's not just with penny stocks being meticulous. It's, you know, working nonstop, being meticulous. I was actually bored one time at a family Thanksgiving dinner. And I was like, let me just get away. Let me just, you know, respond to my messages. I try to respond to everybody's messages. Sometimes I get behind. During this one Thanksgiving, I don't know if you know, you have two Facebook inboxes. Do you know that? You have like people who you're connected to.
Yeah.
So I never check the ones that I'm not connected to.
Me neither. I'm literally
just looking to get away from my boring family. And I'm like, all right, I got to go check messages. Sorry. So I check this inbox and literally I'm inboxed from this producer from Steve Harvey like 2 weeks ago. I never checked it. And they're like, we're doing a show on young millionaires. Would you like to be a part? And I'm like, yes, of course. And I, you know, call her right immediately and we set it up all in a week. He flies out two of my students. He flew me and, you know, my parents out. We all went to Chicago. It was an amazing experience, not just because the episode was great and it was good for business, but he literally went off script. He had like 7 questions for me, but he went way off script with a live studio audience. And we're there for like 2 hours and we're, you know, it gets cut into like a 10-minute thing, but he actually wanted to know about my process and everything. And it was just, it was an amazing experience.
That is so cool, man. That is so, and how about Larry King? How'd you get on that?
So we know a lot of the same people. I'm Jewish, he's Jewish. All the Jews hang out and we all eat bagels, you know, like it's pretty cool. And we got connected and we both have very sarcastic sense of humor. You know, like when I'm on his show, you know, he's like, oh, so you started with your $12,000 in bar mitzvah gift money. That's $11,500 more than I got. And it was, you know, that's what I started with, my bar mitzvah money. So that's Jew power right there.
And so right now you're young, you're a multimillionaire, you build this empire. You know, what drives you right now? I mean, you have everything you want. I've gone on your Instagram. I see all the cool things that you do, all cool people you hang around with and the lives you change. You know, becoming, you know, a multimillionaire in your 20s, you know, I mean, how do you stay humble and what's next for you?
I mean, I've had my bouts with cockiness before, and then usually like the world or the markets, you know, crash me down and bring me back down.
God humbles you.
Yeah, and it's very good. Travel humbles me. You know, I go all over the world, but there's only so many luxury resorts and so many pina coladas that you can have before you're like, what more is there for life? Like, I bought all my childhood dream cars. I bought, you know, Ferrari, Lamborghini. I got a Rolls Royce. I had a second Lamborghini. But when I got the second Lamborghini, I was like, why am I not, you know, getting this dopamine hit? Why is there no adrenaline rush? So the things that I wanted as a child no longer really thrilled me. It was cool to drive them, but then you evolve. And now I'm like, what else can I do? When I travel, I start seeing like, you know, I went to Bali, I stay at these beautiful resorts, but then you see a lot of local people, they're not living very luxuriously. And then, you know, I started talking with the locals, what can we do to help? I found somebody to build a school in Bali, my first school. I started building schools. Now I've built 70 schools with my charity. My goal is to build 1,000 plus. Education, especially in third world countries where they have no chance whatsoever, that's what drives me. Now teaching too, education, just using this new technology. Like we wouldn't be able to do this kind of talking back and forth across the country in real time a few years ago. So I'm excited to build schools where communities never had education. I'm excited to share real lessons over the internet and seeing what education can do. You need challenges and you need goals. And so for me, I always try to dream big and then I try to figure out what makes me happiest. So now I'm happier when one of my students makes like 10 grand in a day versus me. Like I want to obviously still profit, want to donate more to charity, I love it when a student gets it for the first time. Like I think back in the year 2000, when I was a college freshman, I had my first $100,000 day. I had like 3 fake IDs taken away from me. I couldn't even get into bars. I'm downloading illegal movies on Merck on my computer, and I make $100,000 in a day. I'm like, what is going on here? And I actually sold too soon. Like a day later, it would have been like $200,000. But I was on the right track, and I want that feeling for everybody else. When you start to realize you don't have to just be a doctor or lawyer to make big money. You don't have to follow your parents' dreams. You follow your own dreams. You get passionate. The world is an amazing place. And I just want to pass that down.
Awesome, man. So tell me about, what is Kamigawa?
So it used to be the Timothy Sykes Foundation, named after myself, you know, building all these schools. But I guess a lot of rich guys, like they like putting their name on like schools and like hospitals and stuff. But every new school opening, like all the kids would be like, Tim. And I was like, no, this isn't about me. Like I donated the money, but I don't need this like praise. And it was weirder and weirder. And I was like, I don't want this. So I took on a partner. His name is Matt Abad. He's a photographer. So we don't just build the schools. We also go to the openings. We take photos and videos with the communities. We show what we're doing. It's pretty cool that in Bali now we've built 21 schools. But because we share it on social media, we have now built 16 more schools through our followers' donations. So we share all of that. And Kamigawa, you know, karma, good karma. Gawa is in the Tagalog language of the Philippines, which my partner Matt is Filipino. And it means to do or to make. It's like we're making good karma by donating money and then sharing it. And you know,
I love the name. I love
it. We actually have 1.2 million followers now on Instagram. Grown 100,000 since we set this up a few weeks ago. It's grown.
And you're a big, you know, big advocate for animal rights. And you know, you have, you know, also, what is it, you know, Save the Reef Foundation. Is it a foundation? You know, and, you know, what you know, tell me about that and why and you know, why you are so passionate about animal rights. Obviously, you know, we know about that, but what got you into that, and tell me the mission for Save the Reef.
Yeah, so I mean, schooling is great, but that takes years or decades. When we started traveling around and building more schools, we saw a lot more urgent issues. We were in South Africa. I didn't even know that, you know, rhinos are going to go extinct in the next 5 or 10 years at the rate that they're getting killed. So we did a mini documentary on rhinos. We met some other videographers. They were telling us about how the coral reefs are getting, you know, just destroyed, and that's going to kill our marine life and ecosystems. So we did a documentary on coral reefs last year. Amazing. Got like 4 million, 5 million views on YouTube. Started donating to a lot of charities, the reef, and, you know, saving sharks, because shark finning is such a problem. So we kind of didn't plan this. You know, we just see problems. Some of them are more urgent than others. So we try to make documentaries, we do donations, and we do posts. I just did a post on Save the Reef literally like 3 days ago, how, you know, on masks, disposable masks, animals are getting stuck in the straps. So we did a post. One of our community members made a graphic where you just cut off the straps and the animals won't get trapped. And that thing has, you know, 1 million shares now in like 4 days. People are like, I never knew. So it's about spreading awareness, helping the animals, making this kind of a better planet for everybody.
Awesome, brother. Timothy, you know, if people want to enroll in your course, know more about your course, you know, first of all, where they go, you know, and how can people, you know, find out more about you? You know, I want you, your YouTube channel, everywhere that we can follow you. Because obviously, man, you know, I think that what you offer right now, it's needed, especially like you said, you know, unemployment is at the all-time highest.
Yeah.
Stock is at the all, you know, is doing great. So
and
why
you can
not
work from home? Yeah, this is the time to work from home.
So you get all the time in the world. Instead of watching Netflix and wasting your life, you know, learn a new skill, which is great for your brain. You know, make yourself proud and make some money, you know, while you're sitting at home. I mean,
I think
what you're offering is what's needed in today's world and today's economy.
Thank you. No, I'm glad you get it. Just, you know, do a Google search for Timothy Sykes. You know, you can find my blog. I've got 3,000 blog posts on timothysykes.com, 1,500 videos on YouTube. I have, you know, more comprehensive and condensed guides. Everyone gets to choose how dedicated they will be. But all of my top students study 3, 4, 5, 7. One student even studies 17 hours per day, just looking at different charts, looking at different sectors. And, you know, his name is Roland. He turned 4,000 into 1 million. He was having problems because he had 2 new babies. His wife was working. He was working. And he was like, this is impossible. He got into trading. Now he's made enough and he's, you know, self-sufficient. He doesn't need me anymore. I'm just training wheels. So that's my goal for everybody. Anybody can do this. They just need to study hard and not listen to anybody who's like a doubter or negative. There's so many negative people in this world. Tune them out. Tune out toxic people. Tune out toxic stocks. Focus on the positive. Focus on yourself. You will be surprised at what you can accomplish with enough dedication, with enough patience, especially if you love what you do. It's all about passion.
Well, thank you so much, Mo. Thank you so much for being, you know, being on the show. You know, really appreciate it. We're going to put everything on the show notes, you know, and looking forward to following you. And man, I'm going to get one of my guys to do this, man. I want to, you know, because I'm like, you know, I'm just curious. For me, I just like to learn a new skill. You know what I mean? I don't know if I want to learn it for 9 months, but I would love to just play around with it. And, you know,
well, it's interesting now, especially it's just entertainment. Even if you don't make any money, it's entertaining to see how like these penny stock scammers come out with like, oh, we have a new coronavirus vaccine. And it's like, no, wait, no, you really don't. You don't have any money. You're just, you know, lying. And so like, it's comedy to me what some of these scammers try to do. So a lot of the time I just expose scams. I don't even trade the stock. I'm just like, hey, look at this scam. And for me, it's like, it's crazy that people believe it, but thanks to the internet, we can now all do like investigative research and investigative reporting. So I think it's a great time to learn.
Thank you so much, Timothy. Thank you so much for being on the show.
Looking thanks for having me, man.
You prosper and stay in touch, brother. Thank you.
Thanks. Cheers. Stay safe.
Hey guys, if you like today's episode, do me a huge favor. Go ahead and leave a comment below, subscribe to the channel, leave me a review, and tag a few friends that you think can benefit from what we shared today. Really appreciate it. God bless.